Okay, I'm gonna play some more of this. Place adventure last time. I'm not barbarian. That's who I should play. Barbarian is bigger, slow, more health, more strength. Can't wear armor, and has a very large sword which is slow. But it has the same damage, has a much longer range. Fierce adventurer has 5 strength, 80 health. Barbarian has 90 health, 10 strength. Same crit genius. And moves at 85% speed. So, first things first, as always, destroy the barrels. This is where the dodge roll becomes important, because you move at normal speed with dodge roll. I stay on normal for now. So slow. Do not normally play it because the slowness. Did you stop with the skeletons? It's a fireball. This is Tim's sister, Tim. Sister of Tim the Alchemist in the camp. During the Halloween update, Tim the Alchemist in the camp was replaced with Blackwing, one of those witches. Also, we decided to call her Tim. So, she's still Tim. Obviously that's a pit. I wish she's not taking quite as much damage. Especially considering I'm only on normal. I've got a forest den. You can generally leave enemies behind you relatively safely. You just keep an eye on them. Make sure they don't sneak up on you. This is a forest den. It has usually a pretty huge duck on it. Fancy wooden chest. Big enemy. Maybe one other thing. And it's nice because it gives you extra items from Enchanted Forest. Although weapons cannot drop on the Enchanted Forest. So it's can't give you any weapons. You get achievement for it. Flame Orb is not very good version. Toxic Elixir of Life. Poison you can add tonight, gives you an extra life. Not very relevant. Flame Orb does this. Why there's drop off on it, I do not. But it's not really a very good item, so. Spell damage is at 0. What a lot of damage that is. I guess it does matter. You should go back to those other axes. I think it's a potion. But I'm losing. Backtracking is for the weak. I didn't think it did, but I know for certain it could die. Big guy. Hopefully get in the pit. Very physical way of getting them. Because of course, doesn't matter how much health they have. They still die to really go in the pit. Right, so this rum will make me really slow. But will cure the poison. parrot pecks enemies nearby. These boots, immunity to fire. They're behind you. Small axe has more damage than this. There's less range, but I generally prefer the damage. So slow. Spin drop. Also. I guess it's the Piers and Pyro Cooper skeletons, which is nice. Oh, I can't move anywhere. My drunkenness will be cured in this next room. Where are I? So I'll be able to walk slightly faster. Ah, haunted it. Exactly what I want. I'll give you some things. And a bit of gold. He uses to get drunk, which I'm not doing. Yeah, it does more damage, and it stuns. Crit chance is 10%. But that's still reasonable. It's respectable crit chance this game. Rooms like this are pretty horrible when you're drunk, because you have rather a tendency to just walk off because you can't walk a straight line. Murky water, random disease. Give me jumping disease. Give me ass disease, which is I believe completely meaningless. This health potion. It's worth noting that you can't dodge roll directly upwards and directly downwards. You can dodge roll left, right, and so roll diagonally, but if you're trying to go straight up or straight down, you have to kind of zigzag a bit. Rain of Arrows is considerably better than the Flame Orb. It causes Rain of Arrows. Like this. It's actually not too bad. brilliant bit of damage there. I guess what I'm hoping for would be a shot. A decent hit. Or a demon dude, devil dude to do a shot. Oh yes, Grand Vizier's terrifying transmutation. He is on fire. Buy this. Because now we can't afford the pits. Buy this, because it's good. I should not have bought that, because now I can't afford the Grand Vizier's terrifying transmutation. It swaps your strength and your vitality. My strength is... Why is my strength 13? Oh, magic juice. So I would have 13 health, which probably is not enough to tank a single hit, but I would have ridiculous strength, so I would do insane amounts of damage. Unfortunately, that's a goblin shot badge drops. I'm not going to buy that. I guess maybe if we get gold rush. So the barbarian axe is fast, so it's fast. Very sensibly. But give me something good. Dying in this room, I refuse. Right. Can't wear armor. Due to his wonderful pets. Morning Star. Take that, Sphodomus. Take this. Which also gives me immunity to fire. That means I am literally on fire. Yeah, we are. That was very lucky. This thing's periodically fire out. Poison. Like that. They can be pretty bad. Not even be able to play a bit bad as my play, so. Not normally very good at dash attacks. When they work, they can be very effective. I'm not very good at making them. This health potion is very useful though. When you play this game co-op, it's considerably easier to stay at higher health as well, because you effectively have twice the damage output. And I believe it does spawn more enemies. It doesn't spawn twice as many enemies, so you clear rooms faster, so you take less damage. And while you do have to split the healing between two of you, on the whole, between you probably usually take less damage, and dying is less serious. It's not fun. I really should be using the bombs. I'm not. Right. There we go. That's him gone. The lifeguard spell that I picked up earlier. will allow me to do this. So I can't dive and fall into pits while I have it on. It's not quite as good as being able to fly over the pits, but it is better than nothing. It also means that if I fail at this and not too often, I won't die. We can beat down 2 scrolls of transmutation. Crossblade is considerably better. Reroll. Achievements. This does considerably more damage. I'm going to take it. Murky water. Yes. Dark. Oh. What was this? The scroll of blessing. Levitation. So, duck madness means everything is a duck. I thought I had the range on that. I was wrong. So, everything will be a duck until the duck madness wears off. What's this? This is those are poison darts. Oh, these spikes. You walk up to them, they do that. When they go down, you can stand on them and you're fine. So I have no idea what that is. It's probably a potion. It is a potion. It was Mountaineer Schnapps. Strength plus 10. Pretty decent. Fish dudes. Triple kill. I might die here. We can also do this. Oh, I can't. That was a bomb. Because it added to the stack of bombs I already had. I was trying to walk into a pit while holding an enemy. In order to kill them. But it didn't work because I can fly. Which is pretty useful. But ruined my dramatic kill. 2 health. And I'm dead. Which will at least cure the duck madness. I honestly can't remember if there was something that dropped earlier. And I lack the desire to go back and look. Demonic altars. Exactly what I needed. Who doesn't like curses? Mighty foot! Take the, yeah, they're full of them, I'll take. Normally a good idea to carry a health potion, so that when we get low, you have on ready, and on form. And generally, the herb potion is the best thing to carry around.
Ooh.
This is slime head. That's a butt. This is a horrible attack. This guy, if you... you can kill the legs. All that does is stop him from spawning the butts. If you kill the main part, right, immediate curses. Well, there's gold jewel. Heal up and get gold. Mountain snaps. It's Mountain Ash. What's this? Heavy Maul. This is a very good weapon. Because it gives you allows you to break shields on a normal hit. So you don't have to do jump attack or anything. It's especially good with anything that lets you kind of continuously attack. Only a couple of items actually need to do that. But this shield breaker works very good. Now, if you if you can fly, you can actually get Bart Simpson to commit suicide. Because if you're hovering over, if you're flying over a thing, I don't have anything to allow me to do this. It's not good. If you're hovering or flying over a thing, then the Bart Simpsons will jump at you off into. To the death. Please don't give me gold rush. No. This is pointless because I'm not getting any gold because I've gold through. A great excuse not to do Gold Rush. Why are you giving up? It does stun on crit. That's why that other guy was stunned earlier. Most effective way to destroy a large number of props at once. If they're alive, they're not. Small print. Yes. I will gladly give up 10 vitality for an extra life. It's not probably not the best item he could have given me. Like the. This skeleton. Oh, it does go across the beach. I did not think it did. Please, oh. What happened there? Hold on. We'll go for that side. That's what I'm trying to do right here. I don't really want to drink that anymore. These fish dudes are very annoying. They have this weird kind of chain attack. They walk forwards. I can't move. Duplicator. Well, I guess I should. I really should go and drink murky water. Big feet, spooks. Yeah, that was basically worst case scenario. But it's not too bad. Guess I can do that. But. I'm not immune to explosions. There we go, unlocks casual mode. It's a very unorthodox method. But it does work. He was hitting himself with it. I dodged that. I think I have immunity to poison. No, I do not. Wait, no. Whatever is this? This is a dungeon, so next is a room now, I think. Yes. I'm so slow, I hate the barbarian. Die! Stop killing me. This parrot's comments are not helping. There's a whole crowd and it can be very difficult to work out when they're trying to throw daggers at you. Oh, Tim! Well, there are two guys. I'm used to having the achievement that means you don't, you only need to, there's one, there's only one phase of lockpick. Oh, I can hear it. Oh. These are amazing. Infinity jump is pretty good. Let's jump through it. Or do I need it? I don't know that I do need it. The damage is at 48, 50, but it's not worth it. Because I can theoretically jump out of bits like that, but I think if I've been knocked over, I wouldn't be able to. So I prefer to have the insurance. So slow. Iron Maiden. Okay, there's a guy there. I have no idea how I didn't get him. This is rather hairy. Alright, that's that done. And then we hope that this is something good. That's not too bad. This is fast. I'm gonna take it. I really should not take this. Being a fast weapon, it would probably do more damage per second. Damage per second than that. And the shield breaking loss is not a massive. Okay, let's go box his head again. Works. Jumping disease. Warlock has been unlocked, probably the strongest class in the game. Mm-hmm. I'm immune to the fire, which is good. I think I'm... Sewer. So we got this floor, then Gothic, and then lab. I should be able to do this. Oh, no, no, traction. This is a pretty solid ledge crouching. It does everything, really. It helps you cross pits, it attacks enemies, it allows you to jump slightly higher, and it opens chests as well. Oh, Wheel of Misfortune. Don't give me anything bad. Don't give me anything too bad. Giants is... I said, or I guess I did say it was so bad. Broken disease. That's done. That's what we do. Wish it does that. Double jump has been acquired. I like it if you can jump anyway. So, this is the other use of the traction. I don't know how you're supposed to do that really at some point in the level. Yeah, this one. So, the room contraption is not great, it's more of a utility item, it's fairly powerful against enemies because you can hit any of them, even ones with a shield, and they can't do anything except sit there and pick them up and throw them to pits. It does damage them slowly, but it doesn't do anything against big enemies, bosses. I do not want to go anywhere near those pumpkins because they will just kill me. That's an old cure. So I do not need. I guess I should. There's people who need this money. Something good. Gift of power. This allows you to teleport. This causes enemies to take crits. To be honest, probably stupid. That gift of power, you can take one and you have to disappear. Hmm. Rampage Knight's got all the rings. Totally got this. Totally have this. Extra life. Never in any doubt. Fine without that. So that's... fairly important use. You can use the Wolf Trapper on him as a shield. It's considerably faster, but don't. Can I, you can! I remember back in the day when familiars used to fire all the time. So Guy Fawkes would just wreck you. But now they only fire when their enemies are good. Which means it's considerably better because it doesn't kill you all the time. Can't go up there because I'll blow up the ice barrel, kill myself with it. You can take candelabras through between rooms, go to your pits. What's the point? Tiny Dominatrix, what's this? Is this the Reaper? Ah! Pretty solid weapon, this. I've got to see its effects. Take this with me. It's the French. I somehow forgotten that I had the tiny dominatrix even though I literally just picked her up. Oh yeah, Guy Fawkes says things as well, not just the parrot. So now I'm going to have twice as many minions trying to obscure it in front of the minions. Unfortunately, I don't have the one thing you need to fight the final boss, the Scroll of Escape, which opens all doors in the room. So you use it on the lab. I'm poisoned as well. Come on, heal up. At least it didn't fall. Unless it strikes back, but it did not. There's a trick for dodging this attack. He's not very maneuverable. I have no idea what he was just about to throw. There are two of them now. Take the health potion, take the Nazi horse, and then demonstrate the thing that must be down there, which is you can drop the magic items. or you want to be slightly behind. Worth noting, you're not actually moving to the right. You can do the... Yes. There he goes. Launching it again. Unless that done. Stats, enemy skills. Let's check this. I haven't won the game on hard. Brought me revenge. So I've nearly got the assassin. Teach me what throwing weapon hits. Hits. Doing magic to get the battle mage. What's that? 33 gold to unlock the pirate? Got that. No. Right. That's all for now.